There are two things that I enjoy in life, Wario and games that remind me of Wario. In the past, I've talked about the Wario Land series and how good it is, as well as a certain indie game coming out in the future that I believe will serve as a worthy continuation. Today I'm here to do the same, but in order to do that, I first need to tell you about Anton Ball Deluxe. Now, anyone could look at this game and tell you that it looks like Breakout crossed with Wario, but I think it's a bit more than that. A single-screen puzzle game combined with platforming elements is something that I took for granted because it really is something that just works. It's the basis for the original Mario Bros., which this game takes heavy inspiration from. Or I guess it should say it takes inspiration from the version of Mario Bros. That was packaged with a bunch of Mario titles for the Game Boy Advance. I will be 100% transparent in saying that a game like this plays perfectly to my nostalgia. The Game Boy Advance port of Mario 3 was legitimately the first game I can remember playing, and I do remember struggling to get past World 1, so you can bet I spent a lot of time playing the Mario Bros. Minigame. It's not just that Anton Ball looks and plays like a GBA game, but it sounds like one too. This is the only modern game I can think of that has this sort of crunchy sound design, where the voice lines have a sort of vibrato and they're repeated and stuff. It's just so good. But if Anton Ball Deluxe is so much like Mario Bros., doesn't it deserve a traditional platformer to go along with it? Of course it does. Anton Blast is basically everything I could ever ask for in a video game. You put three of my favorite 2D games in your list of inspirations and you've already got me on board. Full disclosure, the developers of this game did reach out to me so that I would make this video, but I genuinely would have been all over this game even if they didn't. Really, the only thing that changed is that I got to know about it a day in advance. The same demo I had access to is openly available for free right now through their Kickstarter page, so let's talk about it. In the first 10 seconds of the game, we can basically see everything that I love about it. Amazingly smooth animation, that same crunchy sound design, and a good old bonus room. We've got a shoulder bash equivalent and a way for Anton to bounce off the ground after a jump, letting you gain some pretty satisfying momentum. You'll need to know how to use this to your advantage for the escape sequences, which feels like an obligatory part of the Wario-like genre now. I'm not complaining, I love me some good escape sequences, but understandably the one in the demo is far from having a tight timer, which should be expected for what's essentially level 1. The Anton series does wear its heart on its sleeve when it comes to its inspirations, but if you're a guy like me who just wants Wario Land, but like, more, then it's perfect. It's not just Wario Land 4 that gets referenced here, but there are also elements from Virtual Boy Wario Land, my beloved. The most obvious one is the background and foreground gimmick, but there's also a bonus room with that classic red tint, as well as some Virtual Boy style 32-bit music. I will say, basically my only criticism with this demo is that when you're in the background, the foreground does get in the way. I know this is probably an intentional decision, judging by Anton having a clear silhouette when he's being obscured, so they knew this would happen, but you can't really see anything else besides Anton. For me, a good gimmick should complement the main gameplay instead of obstructing it, and this wasn't an issue in the original Virtual Boy Wario Land. But the nice thing about a demo is that anything and everything is subject to change for the final release. 2023 really can't get here fast enough. Now, unfortunately, donating to the Kickstarter won't speed up the flow of time, but it will ensure that the game gets funded, which is pretty good too. Again, I would literally be promoting this even if they hadn't asked me to, and even if you can't donate, spreading the word about a game like this can be just as helpful. Once again, I have to thank Tony Grayson for sending me the demo and stuff a day early, as well as all the people on screen who made this possible. I know this is a pretty short video, but this is a pretty short demo. The Kickstarter does indicate that there will be 9 worlds, and more with stretch goals. Anton Ball Deluxe had 5 worlds containing 69 levels, but those are all single screen, so while the amount is high, they're obviously not very long. I have like 4 hours in this game, and I have all but 3 of the achievements. It's short but sweet, you know? It's an arcade-style game, something you're meant to pick up and play, and will serve as the perfect partner for what is shaping up to be an extremely substantive platformer. That is all for now. Goodbye.